Let me start with the big story this hour. A fire has broken out at a prominent hotel building in Srinagar, the Pamposh Hotel at Regal Chowk houses many prominent private offices. Firefighters are battling the blaze. The fire erupted on the top floors of Hotel Pamposh. The cause of the fire has not been ascertained yet. These are the latest visuals coming in from Srinagar, where the fire has engulfed Pamposh Hotel. So far, we know that no one has been injured or is trapped inside the building. And so these are the latest visuals coming in from Srinagar, where you can see the fire has completely engulfed Pamposh Hotel. The smoke has been billowing out. So far, no casualties have been reported. But now to bring us more details on this news story, I'm joined in by our correspondent Ishan Vani, who joins us live from Srinagar. Let's quickly go across to Ishan. Ishan, please bring us the latest details from Ground Zero. Have there been any casualties reported so far?
There are no casualties reported so far, but the massive fire has engulfed this five-story hotel. This is known as the mini secretariat. This house is prominent media houses. I spoke to some of the journalists who stay there, who have their offices there. They're unable to get their cameras and other equipments out as there's a lot of smoke coming out. You can see on your screens that fire department is unable to control the blaze because it's so huge. The hotel is big. There were a lot of tourists who were rescued before the fire could actually, you know, engulf the entire hotel. A lot of smoke has filled the hotel. So it is in the heart of Srinagar. That's why it has become a lot of, you know, it's become sensitive. Now police is trying to control the crowd, and fire service department at the same time is trying to douse the fire. But the flame is huge. It started from the top story of this particular hotel and has engulfed and is slowly moving down. But the fire department is trying their best to control this particular fire.
Right. Ishan, also, have there been any reasons quoted for as actually what caused the fire? Has there been any such discussion so far that you're aware of?
Well, yes, police is on the spot, but there is no confirmation. I was at the hotel some time back. There was a little bit of fire in the morning on the ground floor, but it was controlled soon. But now again, in the afternoon, my friends in the media told me, who had stayed there, that they were having lunch and suddenly this fire started, and that from the top building of their hotel. So right now, there are no reports of any casualty or anybody being injured, but the fire department has reached the spot and are trying to douse this fire.
Right, Ishan, also we can see, you know, these are some very dramatic visuals coming in over there, as we can see that the fire has completely engulfed the hotel. There is smoke billowing out. You are over there right now. It's important to speak about this location. You know, Pamposh Hotel happens to be very integral to Srinagar city, as it also houses some of the major media houses over there. Tell us more about this place.
This place is located in the heart of Srinagar. This is Lal Chowk area. The Jhelum just flows right there. I can see that the fire department is installing their motors so that the water could be taken from the Jhelum and are trying to, you know, douse this fire. The importance of this hotel is such that there are thousands of people who have gathered there and are trying and helping the fire department. This is in the heart of Srinagar, and that is why it is spread everywhere. The people are coming here and are trying to, you know, help the fire department. But police has also reached the spot, and you can see on your screens that the fire is coming out from the fourth story now. It was earlier on the top floor, now it has moved down to the fourth story because the backside of this hotel does not have enough space for the fire and service departments to come and douse the fire from the backside. So it has become a difficult operation for them as well. And also, when I reached the spot, I saw a lot of fire service department personnel unable to go inside because there's a lot of smoke. Even I can feel some smoke here, and you know, it's mixed with the air right now, and it has engulfed the hotel completely. Now this is a five-story hotel and is one of the top hotels in Srinagar.
Absolutely, Ishan. As we can see, you know, you just rightly mentioned that this fire started at the from the fifth story of the building, but it has moved on to the fourth story. Clearly brings out how challenging it has been to contain this fire. Also, tell us about the rescue operations. As far as the fighting operations, firefighting operations are concerned, which are underway, how many fire tenders are present at the moment, apart from the police, which has also reported over there?
Well, all the major fire service departments who are located at different locations in Srinagar have been brought here. Because it being in the heart of Srinagar, the fire service is right now trying to, you know, put in the water from different locations. They have come from the backside, as I can see from here. They are trying to, you know, douse this fire, and it should not spread, because there are little houses. There are little houses and also shops and business establishment who are near these houses. So it could be one of the biggest fires if it's not controlled quickly, and it could provide damage to a lot of business personnel who are here in the Srinagar. Remember, Lal Chowk is a big market in Kashmir Valley. If anything happens in Lal Chowk, it becomes a news instantly. So that is why the precaution is being taken, and that the water is being also tried to give to these buildings who are surrounding this particular hotel. There are certain buildings and also shops who are near this hotel, so that becomes important. A big business establishment in Lal Chowk area, and you can see on the top, on the third floor, even now the fire has come down to the third floor. This is where most of the media persons sit, and it is now going down from the backside. Again, to remind you that this is the backside of the hotel, and why is it important? Because on the backside, you cannot have any space for the fire and service department to come and actually throw the fire on the building from the backside. There are people who have not come and are trying to, you know, rescue these hotel people, if any is trapped inside the hotel. But I spoke to the hotel manager some time back. He told me that all the people have been taken out safely, and only the fire service department personnel are being allowed to go inside the hotel and carry out this particular operation. Remember, there are a lot of tourists who come here and stay in this particular hotel. That was the first line of action that the hotel took, that they took out all the guests who were there, who had come from different parts of India and are staying inside this hotel, after which the media persons came down and they tried to go in again to take their equipments out. But as you can see, the smoke has filled the hotel completely, and that's why they're not able to go inside and take out their equipments.
It's actually some respite to know that, you know, all of the people inside the hotel have been evacuated, as you rightly mentioned after your conversation with the hotel manager. This is some respite, but it's important to actually also, you know, focus on the fact that it's a densely populated area, as we can make out from these visuals, and that it's important to also contain the fire as soon as possible. In the meanwhile, Ishan, I would request you to just hang in there. We will come back to you. For the moment, let's listen in to an eyewitness's account that we have right now about this fire.
अचानक, I don't know कि short circuit है क्या है, अभी बोलना बहुत मुश्किल है. तो इस हिसाब से बहुत बड़ा नुकसान है इन द हार्ट ऑफ सिटी. अभी फायर ब्रिगेड आ गए हैं, इंशाल्लाह लगता है कि काबू में हो जाएगा. फर्स्ट ऊपर वाला फ्लोर तो टोटली डैमेज्ड है, तो इसमें बहुत से ऑफिसेज भी थे, बहुत से हमारे जो प्रिंट मीडिया, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया, उन लोगों के ऑफिसेज भी बहुत यहाँ पर है, और होटल में कमरे भी लगे हुए थे. अल्लाह ताला का शुक्र है, जो अभी पता चला है कि जो हमारे टूरिस्ट वगैरह है वो सेफ है.
These are live visuals coming in from Srinagar's Pamposh Hotel, which you can see has been engulfed by fire, and columns of smoke, as you can see, are billowing out of Pamposh Hotel. As our correspondent Ishan Wani just rightly pointed out, that the first priority for the firefighting team was to get the hotel evacuated. Apart from the fact that it houses some of the leading media houses in Kashmir, it also has tourists residing inside the hotel, which was also equally important for, you know, for the firefighting team to ensure that the hotel is completely evacuated. As you can see, the firefighters are still trying to contain this fire. Pamposh Hotel also happens to be located in the densely populated area of Lal Chowk in Srinagar. For more details, let's go back to our correspondent Ishan, who's bringing us the latest from Ground Zero. Ishan, we just heard the eyewitnesses' account, and as he rightly mentioned that, you know, Pamposh Hotel happens to be, you know, the office for several print and electronic media publications. Could this also fire be a result of some major technical error over there?
Well, we don't know yet what is the reason, but there was a mini fire which started in the morning. That's what my friends in media have told who live there. But it was taken care of quickly. But after that, another fire on the top story of the building tells us that there was something fishy, or maybe it's an accident. But how could questions are there being raised by even the people who live there, that how could two fires start in a particular day on a ground story and then on the top story? Even yesterday, there was a mini fire which erupted from the kitchen, but it was doors quickly by the people. But now we can see the fire is spreading. It must be on your screens. These are really dramatic visuals coming to you live from Srinagar. The smoke has completely filled up. We cannot even see the building. There are people on the top built stories of these residential and commercial buildings who are trying their best to control this fire. The fact is one that on the front side of this building, there is a way from which the fire service entered. But on the back side, the fire service could not enter because it's a small area, and now they are bringing these vehicles from the lanes and by lanes. It's taking time for them to install all these pipes so that they could douse this fire. But interestingly, all the media persons have come down. They told us that this is the third fire since yesterday which erupted in this particular hotel, and that is where they think there was something fishy. But we cannot speculate right now. We don't know what was the reason. This is for the police to investigate. But as you can see on your screens, that it is becoming difficult and the fire is coming down. Now I can see the smoke coming out from the third story of this building. If this fire engulfs the entire building, this will mean a huge loss, not only for the electronic media, but also for the hoteliers, tourists who come and stay here, because it's a very scenic place. There's a Jhelum flowing right next to it. And you can see that the fire is coming out from the other parts of this building. And the people who are trying to basically carry out this rescue operation, are trying to douse the fire, are running out from these places, because in the smoke you generally don't see, and there is a possibility that you may lose conscience. And that is why the parameter has been, the police is trying to get them back, and there may be additional reinforcement being sent to this particular place, which may include the rescue teams and the fire service departments who are housed even outside the Srinagar, may be brought to Srinagar to control this fire.
Absolutely. And also, if speculations are to be believed, and if there is any substance to the fact that, there were three fires that took place, why wasn't it contained, and why wasn't there an alert sounded to the firefighting department much earlier? What were they waiting for?
Interestingly, it will be for the time and the investigation that how did this fire erupt, and were there any measures taken by the hotel to control these fires? Because usually you have to have these equipments and fire exits, including the equipments which can help in dosing the fire. So we'll have to see, for the police has to investigate that how did this fire erupt, and was there any lack from the hotels that it could have been harmful, it could have been resulted in the deaths of several tourists and even locals who live and work there.
Absolutely, Ishan. Also, that brings us, to another very important aspect, and a very important, a problem that's been plaguing the entire nation when it comes to fires, not just in Kashmir at the moment, but let's also look at Mumbai, that, there are fires which are taking place time and again. And is India adequately equipped to, handle such situations of crisis?
Absolutely. We saw on the eve of New Year what happened in Mumbai, and how there were procedural lag from these clubs and hotels. Time and time again, government has tried to enforce on them that there has to be this particular thing, that the fire control measures have to be there. There have to be proper equipments to deal with the fire. But what we can see from, right now, and what we can hear from all the people who are inside the hotel, who live there, there was no such equipment available to them so that they could control the fire. They had to run for their life, leaving all the equipments and all their belongings there. And time again, the government has been giving instructions, but there have been again, you know, remember what happened on the 31st December in Mumbai was a grim reminder of what the fire can lead to. This has been happening now. And now you can see on your screen that the wind is blowing fast, which is dangerous for this hotel because wind may help the fire to spread. And now you can see that we cannot almost see the hotel because the wind is blowing fast. It was raining in the morning and now it is the wind is blowing really fast, which could mean really dangerous for this hotel. I can see a person running out from this from the hotel top. He is trying to get away because the smoke has filled the air completely and they cannot see where the fire is coming from. And this wind could mean danger for the people who are there in the relief and the rescue operation, including the fire service department or any other team who is inside this particular hotel. Even the police is trying to help the fire and emergency service department right now.
So as you mentioned, Ishan, you know, the weather is certainly not, in favor of the current situation. As you know, the firefighting team is battling this fire. Have you had any sort of, communication with the firefighters? Have they mentioned how much time the rescue operations could actually take?
Well, yes, when I reached the hotel location, the fire service department was already there. But because the firemen who went inside are the people who are inside the hotel and are carrying out this operation, we don't know what are the equipments. Do they have all the equipments to go inside the hotel? There are specialized equipment with the fire and emergency service, which can help in such situations when there is a lot of smoke into the hotel. But it becomes dangerous for the fire and emergency service department to go inside the hotel at this moment, because there could be, gas cylinders which could explode. We saw similar incident happening in Srinagar some days back. A gas cylinder exploded at a house, which resulted in injuries to some of the people who were carrying out the rescue operations. So they would not want any damage to their men or to the people who have gathered there and are trying to help the fire service department. But a lot of people have gathered at this location. What the police and there may be help sought from the army. We have seen such incidents taking place in the Kashmir. Whenever there's a fire of this massive scale spread, the army is called in because they're also specialized. They also have their equipments. They could help in rescue and, dosing this fire. But right now, only the fire service department officials are carrying out this operation. And there are top officials from the Jammu and Kashmir administration who have reached the spot because it's a high-profile fire, because it's located in the Srinagar center. And if it spreads, it could mean that it could spread to several shops and businesses. Establishment. Business is the backbone of and this particular place and this particular location. I mention again that this particular location is in Srinagar and is the heart of Srinagar where all the business happens. And if anything happens in Lal Chowk, it becomes a massive news. So that is why there are being precautions taken. They don't want any injuries to happen. And as you can see that because of the wind, the fire is spreading in the hotel. It has now moved to this fourth floor. Initially, the fire service department was confident that they would douse this fire within some time. But because the weather is not right and the wind is blowing really fast, that is not helping the firemen to douse this fire. The wind is really taking the flames out, and as you can see on your screens, a lot of men are just moving out of this particular building, which could be dangerous for the building as well as the people who are there, because they cannot see what's happening. There are advanced fire equipments being brought. As I can see, there's a ladder being put on the top floor of this particular hotel, wherein the firemen are trying to go in from that particular location.
Absolutely. As we can see, these are some very, very dramatic visuals coming in. There is thick black smoke billowing out of the hotel with raging flames coming out of the top floors, especially as you rightly mentioned, and the hotel is actually located in Lal Chowk, which is, of course, a very densely populated and heavily commercialized area also, which also makes it equally important for firefighters to ensure that everybody has been evacuated completely from this hotel. Ishan, you mentioned that the police department is also actively participating in these rescue operations. Has there been any sort of communication coming from the police department?
Well, yes, what I saw personally there was that police came rushing towards the spot and they were helping in installing these pipes and they were trying to take these pipes inside the building. The police will now try to assess that how did this fire rage, because again, this is the third fire since yesterday which has raged inside this particular hotel. Although luckily, what we have been hearing from the people who live there, that there were less tourists inside this hotel. And it's a Saturday and usually tourists at the daytime go to different locations throughout the day and they come at night. So their belongings will also be inside their hotel rooms, which haven't been taken out. What I saw on the hotel was that there were only few equipments that the media persons could take, and they were afraid to go inside because the fire is coming down to the third story. And that is where, again, electronic media houses, which are the top media houses of India, are located. And that is where, I would remind you that Wion was first there. The office of Wion was particularly in that hotel only. It has several media houses inside it because of its location. Now it becomes interesting to see that how much time will the fire and emergency service department take to douse this fire. But the flames are still raging on the top floor. As you can see on your screens, there's a thick black smoke coming out of the hotel. And because the backside is again one of the problematic things, that they are not able to move in from that particular side and try to douse the fire.
Also, interestingly, Ishan, as you can see, Twitter is already getting flooded with tweets coming in from most media houses, be it electronic or print media. Everybody is talking about this fire because journalists also seem to be sharing their own personal, connect with Pamposh Hotel, because as I can see on Twitter, a lot of them are sharing their experiences of having worked from Pamposh Hotel in Lal Chowk. And everybody at the moment is actually praying for the safety of everybody in and around this hotel and hoping that this fire is actually doused as soon as possible. But coming to Pamposh Hotel, let's talk about, the heritage that this hotel carries, because as you said, that it not only houses, various media houses, it's also an important place for the tourists to visit. And as we know that, the first snowfall has taken place in Kashmir. This is now the beginning of a season for tourists.
Well, absolutely. This is when the most of the tourists come here, because you will see a lot of snowfall in Gulmarg, Sonmarg, a lot of skiing happening around Kashmir. And again, this is one of the biggest hotels in the Lal Chowk area. The police, police is trying to carry out a relief operation. I can see from here. Now, coming back to the hotel again, this is where actually we used to sit and, do our broadcast, do our lives from this particular location, because it's housed in Lal Chowk area, which is central to Kashmir. There are a lot of people who have come here actually and are tweeting and sending pictures. There are a lot of people who are receiving phone calls from certain people who think that we are still housed there and they are praying for the safety of the loved ones who were inside this hotel, but they have come out safely. There were a lot of media persons and friends from media who were getting calls from their families, relatives about regarding their safety. But now the fire seems to be spreading. You can see on your screen that is the third floor has now been engulfed. And what I heard from the friends in media was that who stayed there, that the top floor, the buildings, there's a lot of wood inside the hotel. Because Kashmir traditionally inside the houses to control the winter, to control, the growing winter conditions, a lot of wood is used inside these hotels, be it hotels, be it houses. So that could be dangerous for this particular hotel. Again, you can see that now the fire service has come from the backside. They are trying to throw the water on the third floor of this building, but it seems that it's becoming difficult because it's a vast building. It would take more than the quantity that is right now available with the fire and emergency service department. They may try to bring all their equipments from the districts where fire service department is housed. They may try to get them to this Lal Chowk area and try to douse this fire. You can see there is also a big maple tree. If it catches fire, it will be dangerous because there are a lot of houses around this particular maple tree. The thick smoke, and we saw that because of the wind, we can see right now that because of this wind and the windy conditions that prevail in Srinagar since the morning. As you said, that there's been snowfall in the upper reaches of Srinagar. That is not helping the relief and rescue operation that is going on currently.
Ishan, it's important to talk about, you know, from our conversation, I've deduced a few points which are important to share at the moment to with our viewers. Because here are the challenges, you know, that the firefighting department could be facing. A, as you rightly and very interestingly mentioned, that there's a use of wood inside these hotels in Kashmir to contain the impact of winter, to actually camouflage these buildings from winter. So it's important to mention how, you know, the use of wood could actually be working against this entire firefighting rescue operation. Apart from the use of wood, there's the wind speed, which is pretty high. As we can see, you've mentioned that, you know, the wind also has been leading to a lot of smoke, and it's one of the causes which has led to the spread of this fire, which has now engulfed the fourth story also in Pamposh Hotel. And thirdly, let's not forget that Pamposh Hotel has also housed electronic media houses, which again use a lot of technical equipment, and there's a lot of heavy wiring done inside these offices. So that could also be one important factor which might delay this firefighting rescue operation. Last but not the least, Ishan, as we can see, it is a densely populated area. There are some other structures also next to the hotel. I hope, and it's important to ask you at the moment, that this fire is not spread over to these other structures aligning the hotel.
Well, yes, right now it's not spread, but I can see there's a flame which is going with the air, and this could be the danger that it could carry with it. Because of the wind, the flames are going out of this hotel, and this becomes important for the fire service to contain these flames, but the weather is not helping. That is one of the reasons a lot of people have gathered in and around this particular hotel who are trying to, you know, help the fire and emergency service department. Some of them are clicking the pictures, but others are informing their families, people who live around this hotel. They are getting calls from their families that if they are okay, from their relatives. But this is massive fire. It's raging. It has come down to the third floor. Fire service department initially thought that this could be, this could take just half an hour or just 1 hour to control this fire. But as we can see right now, it is becoming uncontrollable, and we'll have to wait and watch it, how much time it takes for the fire and service department to control this fire.
Right, Ishan, as you mentioned, that this is a massive fire, and it is, of course, going to be completely challenging for the firefighting department to contain this fire. Let's hope and pray that there are no casualties any further. We will continue to track the latest from you. For now, thank you so much for bringing us the latest details.